Hey everyone! Today we take a look at 18 new mods from the mod Otter Plunket. 7 of these will add a little something to existing locations in the game, another 6 of these mods will add some unique abilities and interesting spells, and the final 5 mods will add other small additions to the game. These mods can be found on the Nexus under the name Plunket's Miscellany. The first small extra is Arcadian's Cauldron. This adds a great looking cauldron to the shop Arcadia's Cauldron, which can be used for alchemy. Felstar Farm adds a fallen meteorite just behind Felstar Farm. Felstar Farm is located in Ivorstadt. The meteorite can be mined, giving you iron and corundum ore. Then we have Four Shields. This adds 4 decorative shields on the wall of the Four Shields Tavern in Drakenbridge. The Scorched Hammer adds a scorched hammer hanging over the door to the Scorched Hammer in Riften. The Sleeping Giant adds a petrified giant to the Sleeping Giant Inn in Riverwood. Four Schools adds 4 mammoth schools scattered around the Four School Lookout. And finally, the Fell Wolf School Cave adds some wolf schools to the Wolf School Cave. In my opinion, these small additions already easily could have been in the vanilla game. I have some really small additions for some extra immersion, I guess. These are very similar to his older work, A Stone in Short Stone. Next, we have 6 unique spells. These spells can be found in Winterhold's prison, the Chill. The mod Arrows to Lockpicks allows you to make lockpicks out of arrows. You do this by wielding an iron, steel or Nordic steel arrow and then cast a spell. You will transform 1 arrow each time. The Dunce Cap is made as a fun spell and it will allow you to put a donkey mask on an NPC's face. Love Cantrip is a spell that will make your target like you more. It can also be used to make nearly anyone a follower of yours, and some NPCs will want to marry you. The Trip Cantrip is something to stagger the target, a good way to get NPCs out of the way that are blocking you. Remove Clothes is a spell that does exactly what you think it will do. In addition, NPCs react in different ways. Some will be embarrassed and flee, others will attack you, and some might even laugh. After a minute or so, they will dress themselves up with plain clothes, and if you wait a while longer, they will restore their main clothing. And finally, we have Spook. This allows you to scare off kiddies. And then we have 5 other small additions to Skyrim. Plunket's Antidote allows you to cook frostbite venom, transforming them in cured poison potions. The Sailor Clothes makes all the sailors in game distinctive with their own unique set of clothes, which in my opinion really goes well in Skyrim. The Lizard on a Stick adds new food called the Lizard on a Stick. These are sold by various merchants and often displayed on the counter. Salt Barrels adds 3 salt ponds to the game. You can extract salt from these barrels. It comes in handy if you cook a lot in Skyrim. And finally we have the target practice for ungrateful bastards. This adds new targets on the Great Porch in Dragon's Reach, the Palace of Kings, atop the Archmage Tower, around Solitude's Marketplace and at the Watchtower close to Whitelon. You get 100 gold for each target destroyed. In addition, you will be reminded to endorse the mods you like to use, you ungrateful bastards. These are some rather small additions to the game. I always found Plunkett's mods are either a lot of fun to use, or they make sense to be added to the game. Plunkett himself has a good sense of humor too, which reflects back in his work. If you liked these, take a look at my other video I made about his mods. Of course, endorsing this mod is much appreciated, and a like or subscribe here is very helpful too. Thanks for watching everyone, have a great day, and I'll see you all next time.